Hey you guys, welcome to this session by Scalers Academy. Today's video is a special beginner's guide for big data analytics. You guys might have come across the term big data and wondered what it is and how it works. In this session, we will learn just that. So we will cover these topics today. What is big data analytics? What is the need of big data analytics? What are the four V's of big data? How is big data stored and processed? Lastly, we will give you a brief about two of the most important aspects in the field of big data, Hadoop and Spark. Let's get started. What is big data analytics? Before we talk about big data analytics, we need to understand big data. Big data refers to the data that involves a large number of varieties where great volume increases with more velocity. Big data analytics deal with collecting procedures, tools, and statistical techniques of big data analytics. Big data analytics helps us gain meaningful insights and valuable patterns from big data to assist in data-focused decision-making. Big data analytics is required because of the rise in big data sources, such as IoT data and social media. Big data analytics is leading to the emergence of study and practice of data science that deals with the processes, technologies, tools, and techniques for data visualization, modeling, cleaning, and mining. Some of the examples of big data are: big data comes from a large number of sources. Some examples are social networks, mobile apps, internet clickstream logs, medical records, emails, documents, customer databases, and transaction processing systems. It can also consist of machine-generated data, Internet of Things devices, and industrial equipments. What is the need for big data analytics though? Big data analytics is used to improve a company's operations using big data to provide enhanced customer service and make custom marketing campaigns and other operations so that the company can increase its profits and revenues. Big data analytics helps a business have a competitive advantage over other businesses that do not use big data analytics to make faster and better business decisions. For example, big data gives valuable insight into the customer's needs, behaviors, and expectations, which the business can use to change their promotions, advertising, and marketing strategies to increase customer conversion and engagement rates. Big data is also being used in the medical field by medical researchers to examine risk factors and disease signs to help doctors diagnose medical conditions and illnesses in people. Some more examples of how big data is used in businesses are: big data analytics is used in the energy industry to identify the potential locations for drilling and examine pipeline operations for gas and oil companies. Big data analytics helps financial service organizations undertake risk management and conduct real-time analysis of market data. Big data analytics is used by transportation companies and manufacturers to optimize their routes for delivery and manage their supply chains. It is also used for smart city initiatives, crime prevention, and emergency response by the government. Breaking down the four V's of big data. The four V's of big data refer to four dimensions of big data: the veracity, velocity, variety, and volume. Volume. Volume is one of the most common characteristics of big data. Most big data environments contain a large amount of data because of the nature of the data being stored and collected. Stream processing systems, system log, and click streams are some of the biggest sources that produce a large amount of data on a regular basis. Variety. Big data also involves a large variety of data that can include unstructured data such as multimedia files, documents, and texts, structured data such as financial records and transactions, and semi-structured data such as streaming data from sensor and web servers log. Many data types are required to be managed and stored in big data systems. Also, big data applications often consist of multiple sets of data that cannot be integrated upfront. For example, big data analytics can attempt to forecast the sales of a particular product by correlating the data of past customer service calls, sales, online reviews, and returns. Velocity. Velocity is the third most important aspect of big data. It refers to the speed at which the data is being produced. Thus, the data being generated has to be analyzed and processed. In most cases of big data, the data is updated on a regular real-time basis. Managing the velocity of data is very important for big data analytics as it expands to AI and machine learning, where big data analytics processes the patterns in data automatically to generate insights. Veracity. Veracity is the degree of accuracy of the big data and how trustworthy the data sets are. The collection of raw data from multiple sources can lead to quality issues in data and make it difficult to pinpoint the required information. So the data must be fixed by data cleansing process to avoid analysis errors. It is also important that the analytics and the data management teams have adequate amount of data to generate valid results. Some big data analytics scientists also describe more V's in the list of components of big data. Many lists have made with even 7 to 10 V's of big data. Some of these examples can be value and variability. Value refers to the data collected, which is valuable and beneficial for the business. Not all data collected will be useful. As a result, businesses have to confirm if the data collected is relevant for the organization before it is used for the project. Variability refers to big data that may have many meanings or are formatted differently. It leads to further complications in handling big data analytics and its management. These 6 V's are the popular in the big data analytics and management: velocity, value, variability, veracity, variety, and volume. How is big data stored and processed with big data analytics? The data collected is stored in a file called the data lake. Data lakes can support many data types and are based on big data platforms such as NoSQL databases, cloud object storage services, and Hadoop clusters. The use of the cloud is popular for big data systems as it is a cost-effective way to get such processing capacities for big data analytics and management. Businesses can use their systems, which are cloud-based, to manage big data services from the providers. The number of servers can be increased according to the requirement of cloud users to finish the big data analytics projects. A cloud user only has to pay for storage and the time used in computing. Hence, the cloud is used for big data analytics by organizations to process and manage big data. What are the keys to an effective big data strategy? In any business, creating a big data strategy involves understanding the goal and target of the business and the data available for the use. Also, evaluating the need for generating further data to assist in meeting the organization's objective is important. The next few steps include the following: sequencing planned application and use cases according to their importance, finding new tools and systems which are required, forming a deployment guide, and examining internal skills to identify if hiring or retraining are needed. To make sure that set of data are used properly, clean and consistent quality of data management and data governance programs must also be prioritized. Some of the other best practices to analyze big data consists of focusing on the needs of the business for relevant information over available technology and incorporating data visualization to assist in data analysis and discovery. What are the uses of big data analytics? What are some of the most prevalent uses of big data analytics? Here, we describe some of the most prevalent uses of big data analytics today. Starting with customer analytics. Big data analytics is used for many purposes, such as mass customization, finer segmentation, one-to-one marketing, and micro-marketing for business customers. Organizations can make personalized strategies for their services and products based on big data analytics. Operation analytics. Operation analytics assists in enhancing the entire decision-making process and the result it produces using new and pre-existing data of a business to improve it with IoT and machine data. Big data analytics has made it possible for organizations to explore opportunities and face new challenges in healthcare sector to optimize healthcare spending, to enhance planning, predicting, and monitoring of the clinical trials in response to COVID-19 pandemic. Fraud prevention. Big data analytics has the potential to offer massive leverage to industries by helping them reduce fraud and anticipating fraud attempts in advance. It is particularly useful in insurance and financial sector. For example, insurance companies can use real-time data for call center notes, voice recordings of a customer, weather, attorney expenses, medical claims, earning, and demography. real-time data help derive predictive models using the information collected to identify and examine fraud claims beforehand. Price optimization. Big data analytics is used by companies to increase their profit margin by examining big data to find the best price. A data-driven price optimization strategy can help companies set prices according to the cluster of segments and products based on the data collected and insights derived from the data. Large companies find it stressful to map the complexity and consider very small detail prone to changing regularly. What are the biggest big data management technologies? There is a big ecosystem of big data technologies used for various applications in big data analytics, but they are often deployed combined. Hadoop is one of the biggest names in big data technologies. It is open source and was released in 2006 as a distributed processing framework, which was at the center of most of the big data architectures initially. Later, Spark and other engines emerged to push MapReduce, Hadoop's engine, to the side. Many technologies offered by big data managed services are offered by IT vendors in a single package. Some of the offerings are Microsoft Azure SD Insight, HPE Esmeril Data Fabric, Google Cloud Dataproc, Cloudera Data Platform, Amazon EMR. What is Hadoop's big data technology? Hadoop is a software used to store and process data. It is one of the most commonly discussed big data technologies. Hadoop started in 2006 as a Yahoo project and later became a top-level Apache project. It is a general-purpose, open-source form of distributed processing with many components such as HDFS, the Hadoop Distributed File System that can store files in a Hadoop-native format to parallelize the data across a cluster. YARN is a scheduled coordinator that coordinates runtime of applications, and MapReduce is the algorithm that processes the data. These are the basic components of Hadoop. Apart from these, Hadoop also has Scoop, which moves data into the Hadoop distributed file system. Hive is the SQL-like interface that allows users to run their queries with the Hadoop distributed file system, and Mahout is used for machine learning. Hadoop is not only used for file storage, but also when Azure blobs or S3 buckets as input. Cloudera is largest vendor for Hadoop by scope and size. And there are other vendors available such as Hortonworks and MapR. Hadoop is available as open source software with Apache distribution as well. What is Spark Big Data Technology? Spark emerged after Hadoop. It is fairly newer project. It was first developed in 2012 at UC Berkeley at AMP Lab. It is also one of the biggest names in Apache project focused on data processing across a cluster in parallel, the biggest difference being it's in memory. Hadoop writes and reads files to Hadoop distributed file system. Spark processes the data in RAM using an RDD, which stands for Resilient Distributed Dataset. Spark either runs in standalone mode or in conjunction with Mesos. With Mesos, the Mesos masters replace the YARN or the Spark master for scheduling purposes. Spark is structured around the Spark core, which is the engine that drives the RDD abstraction, optimizations, and scheduling. It also connects the correct file system to Spark files such as the Elasticsearch, RDBMS, S3, or HDFS. Many libraries work on top of the Spark core, which also includes Spark SQL that allows a user to run SQL-like commands on the distributed dataset. Similarly, MLlib is used for machine learning and GraphicX is used for graphic problems. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope now you understand what big data analytics is and how it works. We will see you next time with new informative videos on variety of topics. Please make sure that you like this video and comment below mentioning the industry that produces the highest volume of big data. Make sure you subscribe to our channel to stay notified with our new updates every day. And don't forget to share the video with your peers. Thank you so much once again for coming this far with us. We will see you next time.